What's up, guys? One thing I absolutely love about Southern California is that I felt as if it was comparable to the amount of vegan and vegetarian restaurants that I found in New York City and suburbs, subdivisions, boroughs of New York. I've been really impressed by from Harlem to Brooklyn. I haven't dined in Queens as far as vegan and vegetarian places, but all over Manhattan you'll find some of the best. I was in Brooklyn one time and I actually had some vegan sushi. It was incredible. And the thing that was different from the sushi that I make was that they actually took it was made with black rice, which is actually a really, really good rice to have. But a lot of the ingredients that they use were like vegetables, but had like a kind of like sashimi flavor. So they might take, like a carrot and soak it. And you'd just be surprised, like between the texture and the taste, it was incredible. And actually my favorite restaurant that I've ever been to is in Manhattan. It's an Asian place. It's called, what is it called? Gingers, Luan Gingers. And there's a couple different of them and it's phenomenal. But Southern California had some great, great places for vegans and vegetarians. And True Food Kitchen is not exclusively vegan and vegetarian. These days, I am kind of more hesitant to eat at places that aren't exclusively vegan or vegetarian. And the reason for that is because of cross-contamination. I cook my own food. I haven't actually eaten at a restaurant in probably, what is it? It's almost June. So we're going on almost a year and a half since I've actually had a meal at a restaurant. But the main reason why is because of this idea, for example, one of my favorite things is sushi. And sushi is raw fish. And so, yes, I like vegan sushi. I like avocado rolls. I like the veggie rolls with carrots and things like that. I really like the seaweed, not the seaweed that they use to wrap it, but the green, you know what I'm talking about, the green seaweed. I love that stuff. But the idea that raw seafood, raw fish and tuna and all of those things are actually going on that same chopping board, that they're potentially preparing the veggies and the same silverware and the same knives, it is kind of, in my mind, cross-contamination. And as much as I used to love sushi, one of the issues that you may encounter with sushi is the fact that not only is there a lot of mercury in the ocean, but there is also, some of the fish that we like to enjoy, some of the sea life that we like to enjoy are scavengers. So I know some people, who are Jewish who won't eat shellfish. And I know some Rastas that I know, they don't eat shellfish. They'll eat a red snapper. They might do salmon, they might do a kingfish, but they won't do shellfish because it's the scavenger. So it's literally cleaning up the ocean. So it's picking up like my favorite thing in the world used to be oysters. Baked oysters, fried oysters, but oysters are scavengers. So their responsibility is to pick up all the crap in the ocean. And a vegan friend of mine told me, look at a shrimp before its head is cut off and things like that. It basically is like the cockroach of the sea. And so you can kind of think about it like that. And that was one of the hardest things for me to give up as a vegan, seafood. But when you started thinking about the idea that you can throw a dead body into the ocean and a lot of the scavengers will eat at that dead body. So you're ingesting what they ingest. And the second part of cross-contamination is the fact that sea life can be very parasitic. And so if you are eating sushi, even if you are a vegan, but you're eating at a sushi place that is preparing, raw sushi, raw fish and sashimi and things like that, parasites and bacteria they're not just gonna stay within that, fish. It can very easily get cross-contaminated. And a lot of times people think that they're overeating because they're just hungry, but a lot of times it's the parasites that are within you that have insatiable appetites that just keep you, they're literally feeding off of you. They're feeding off of the things that you eat. They're feeding off of your life source. They're feeding off of all of that stuff, your energy. A lot of times those things are going to the parasites. And so it is recommended that, you know, you do detox, and it is recommended that, you know, although when I, back in the day when I ate red meat, I preferred more like medium to medium rare, but having, you know, something that's thoroughly cooked would probably limit the exposure, the potential exposure to parasites. And so what I'm going to be doing today, I know that that was a mouthful, but I do miss sometimes eating at restaurants because I like to try different things. I like to try new things. And it was so interesting when I moved to Southern California, I was going on, you know, I was single, dating or whatever, and it seemed like it was 3 dates in a row. Like, it was 1 date in LA and 2 dates in San Diego, and they all recommended the same spot. They all took me to the same place, True Food Kitchen. And so that became like one of the places that I really liked. And True Food Kitchen had this basically like goddess, it was like a grilled vegetable, just smorgasbord of just delicious vegetables, and they served it with a goddess dressing, and that was like my favorite thing. So I'm gonna do my best to try to recreate this True Food Kitchen, you know, veggie medley, and I'm gonna do a dip with it, and it's really good for a company. If you want to snack, because I do snack sometimes, but I try to snack on healthy things. And then also, I have a zucchini in there that I know is, it's like, it's got to get eaten right away, you know, and I don't like throwing out food. So follow me, guys. We are going to be trying to recreate this True Food Kitchen veggie medley with a homemade dressing. It's gonna be tasty. And I got my cocktail, my spritzer. Little Perrier, good to go. All right. All right, guys. So what do I have right here? I got cauliflower. I have my zucchini and I have some green beans. And you can literally do whatever you want. I'm using the veggies that I have here. And who is this? I met this guy actually when I was in LA also. Kem, nice guy, really nice guy. Brief meeting. I was in LA one day. It was right around the BET Awards, and MC Light was having a party. And was Remy there? I think Remy Ma was there, Papoose was there, a couple people were there. She does a annual charity, like MC Light does like a lot of charity work, like, she does a lot of stuff for the kids. And this is an annual thing that she does for scholarships, specifically for inner city young males, you know, like young inner city boys whose moms, you know, may want them to go to get higher education, but can't afford colleges. And so she does a lot of good work. And I actually met him there at one of her rooftop events. Really, really, really nice guy. All right, so these green beans are virgins, meaning that they're like this, right? I don't want this part though. I don't, that's not what I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and chop off the top of this. Chop off the top. Yeah, I'm all about charity, you know, like in any way, shape, or form. And charity comes in a lot of different ways. Everybody thinks that charity is monetary. You know, you can have a charitable heart. You can give, like, sometimes some of the clothes that my mom gave me, or, you know, some of the things that don't fit me anymore, I'll put a bag together and give that away. You know, you can mentor somebody, that's charity. Like, mentor a kid, giving advice. You know, there's a lot of ways to give back because we're so blessed. And even just the idea of living in America, you know, like, as much as I definitely have my critiques, you know, of this country, the country that we live in, you know, things that we take for granted, just like clean running water. It's just something like a lot of people is like, you know what I mean? It's like a lot of people just don't have those types of things. So, you know, even what's considered poverty in America is considered wealth globally. It's an interesting perspective, right, guys? All right. So I'm just chopping the heads off of these green beans. It's going to be delicious. Delicious, delicious. See this? I hope you can see this. Ooh. All right, cool. You can see it now. Now with cauliflower, you guys see, this is my second cauliflower thing. Cauliflower is amazing because you can eat it just as is. Like, you don't have to cook your cauliflower. It's delicious, like raw. And so you could, if you wanted to do this meal raw, you're more than welcome to do. I would say, I've never had raw zucchini, but I believe it's in the cucumber family. So I don't know, maybe you can. But I would say if you want to switch up the zucchini and do like cucumber, if you want to do it completely raw, that would be your choice. So I'm just drizzling olive oil on this flat skillet. See? Plain and simple. You know, summertime is nice because for me, it's like summertime you eat kind of light. Wintertime is a lot of stews. I might do my okra stew, my okra bean stew, which is, I love it. I can eat it year round. But you know, wintertime is more hearty stuff. Summertime you eat kind of more light. So it's a lot of fresh salads. You know, throwing some veggies on the grill is a cool idea. But we're not grilling today. We are throwing these veggies in the oven. All right. So I'm just slicing a little part off this zucchini that looks a little funny. Okay. Now also another thing you can do is if you have a food dehydrator, you can go ahead and throw these on the food dehydrator. I tried to do the string beans on a food dehydrator. I was hoping that it was gonna turn out, you know, like those snap peas snacks that are like crunchy, like they're almost like the texture of potato chips and they're delicious. That's what I was hoping, but it didn't quite turn out like that. Maybe it depends on the food dehydrator that you have, but the one that I have, it more turned out like apricots. You know, like the dried apricots, that texture. So kind of a little bit more chewy and whatnot. So, I don't know if there's gonna be enough room for all of these vegetables, but I will. If you need to get a bigger pan, get a bigger pan. But this is what we got going on right now. I might save a little bit of this cauliflower and eat some of it raw. I'm just breaking up the head of the cauliflower right there. Okay, that's good. Now, got the oven preheated. Let's season up these veggies. What is this? Some sea salt. So speaking of vegan places, there's this place right by where I, there was this place right by where I live, off of Georgia Avenue. And it was a Caribbean vegan place, but like really like prided themselves on it not being like, cause there's a lot of vegan places, but there's a lot of vegan places that like really overdo it with the processed food. And so it's like, you know, the truth is, yes, you can have grilled cheese sandwiches, even vegan cheese or you know, burgers every single day. That stuff is vegan too. And beer, you know what I'm saying, every single day. And that's vegan. But there's a lot of places that do like a lot of deep fried, you know, they do a lot of deep fried like processed food. And you're still getting, like, you're still eating, like, a lot of bread, a lot of, like, starch, you know. You're still eating, like, just a lot of crap. And so, yes, it may be absent of meat, but that doesn't make it healthy. You know what I mean? Like, you know, not to judge anybody here, but I feel like one of the primary goals of being vegan is for optimization of your health. And so you can be plant-based but still be eating a lot of crap. Okay, guys. So I got the sea salt on here. Let me stop snacking on this cauliflower because it's gonna be all gone before it's time to put it in the oven. I am also going to be adding some onion powder on my veggies. Now this one's kind of got like a wide thing going on, so I have to be very careful with being very delicate when I sprinkle it. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. What is this? This is cayenne. And these are also things that I will be putting inside of my goddess dressing. So I'm just gonna do a little bit of cayenne because I like my stuff spicy, and you can not do the cayenne pepper, but I will be putting cayenne pepper in the goddess dressing. This will not be a green goddess dressing, but if you do have avocado, you can make it green. Just add some avocado, but I'm not doing that today. What else? Garlic powder. And it depends on what you want to do. I mean, I'm kind of tempted to maybe do like an Indian flavor for the collie. And so what I'm thinking is I'm gonna add a little bit of cumin and turmeric on the cauliflower. Turmeric is really good for everything. Just like I was saying with ginger, like get the turmeric and incorporate that into your diet on a regular, because turmeric is excellent. And Indian food is one of my favorite types of food, so I do like a lot of Indian recipes. So I run through this stuff. And then cumin. Thought I had one open already. Yes. A little bit of cumin, just on the collie. You know, you can do different types. You know, if you want to do like Asian style vegetables and get the soy and get the, you know, you can even do like a wasabi avocado dressing. It's really up to you. But that is it for now. It's going in the oven. Okay, let's get our dressing started, guys. So, I got this little tiny mixing bowl, which actually serves quite well for company. You know, throw your dip in here or whatever. So this is Follow Your Heart Veganaise, and this is like one of the best vegan mayo substitutes. That was another hard part about going vegan. I thought that I was never going to be able to have mayonnaise again. I am one of those people who really liked mayonnaise a lot, but Veganaise is really good, and it's one of the best ones that you can get. It's like a very organic mayonnaise, and I like the name Follow Your Heart, guys, you know. Follow your heart. I was listening to a speaker and it was talking about the power of your heart and how, you know, we always think it's the mind, but your heart is really like, your heart is like a larger component of your body as far as the governing of your body, really, than your mind. So I like the name, Follow Your Heart. And that's what I always do. I always follow my heart, guys. Many people say, don't do this, don't do that. And I say, you know what? That's fine. But I'm gonna go ahead and follow my heart. Okay, what else? So we got some onion. Let me get a baby onion. To the music. Yes. Now with the onion, like, I mean, onion is a very powerful, vegetable. So it's like, it will take over your dressing if you don't be careful. So you don't want to do too much onion. But again, it's about how much dressing you're making. And the key with this one is you want to chop it very, very, very finely. If you want to, you can even put it in the food processor. I might just end up doing that. But let me walk you guys through how to make it first. The food processor is wonderful because it's gonna blend everything like very smoothly. And you'll still get that onion in there, but you're not gonna have like the chunks of onion. The food processor is one of your best friends. You can do all kinds of things. You can make hummus. I made a hummus yesterday. Whatever dressing you really want to make, you can make with that food processor. So you see, I'm dicing, if you can see, I'm dicing the onions like really, really finely. Very, very, very finely. I'm gonna put red peppers in my dressing as well. Just a little bit. And you don't have to be so like meticulous about the dicing again if you're using a food processor, which I've decided I'm gonna go ahead and do. So, but if you're not, dice it real, real, real fine. It depends. This has actually been the best food processor I've ever gotten. I'm very pleased with it. It's a Ninja food processor, and you can get it from Target for under $20. Next, just a dash of mustard. Just like a little bit. A little bit of mustard. That's all. I'm adding cayenne. Onion, and yes, onion powder too. Cloves of garlic. Mm-hmm. Just a dash of chili powder. And a little bit of paprika. Just a bit. So, got all this stuff in here. Guys, it's fantastic. Oh my gosh. The red pepper is amazing. I'm gonna add more because it's so good. Oh my gosh. I need to blend it a little bit more because that clove of garlic is hitting me. Yeah, that garlic clove is hitting me. So it's got to get blended down. So if you want to do garlic powder instead of a garlic clove, I say do it. But like I said, fresh garlic is always a better option than the powdered stuff. Yeah, more red pepper for sure. It is so good, guys. But guess what? I forgot one thing. The sea salt. It needs just a little bit of sea salt. Oh my gosh. Goodness gracious. It's really good. Guys, this is really delicious. It's perfect. So like I said, if you want to do raw, you can. You're more than welcome to. I got some leftover cauliflower here right now. Now, you don't want to keep your veggies in too long. If you want them to still have that little bit of crispness, it may be a good idea to take them out after 5 or 10 minutes. Use a fork, guys, and be civilized, for God's sake. So when it comes to food, sometimes simplicity is better. This is delicious. I'm gonna take my dressing, my red pepper dressing. Voila. I got my red pepper. Definitely. No question. This is banging, guys. It's really good. It's really good, guys. It's the dressing. No, the dip. It's the dip that really. I almost feel bad. Almost, but not really, that you guys aren't here to enjoy this with me. But you know, when it comes to the food, more for me. Okay. That's why I'm not overdoing it, but it's dinner time, guys. Until next time, y'all. Peace, bon appetit, and remember, always say grace.